All right, so Steve Dahl, why are you back in terrestrial radio?
I am back in terrestrial radio because I missed it. I missed being part of the daily conversation. And I also am partnered with Cumulus Radio, and we're kind of trying to create some synergy between the terrestrial radio and the podcast.
Did it get boring in your basement?
I have to say that I enjoyed 6 years in my basement, but I don't mind coming downtown every day and, you know, getting to walk around and see stuff, and it's fun.
How is the energy different in the radio studio than it is for podcasting?
Actually, the energy at this radio studio is very similar to the energy in my basement, because we're on a essentially deserted floor. There are like five people on this entire floor at 190 North State. So it's very much like, it's very disconnected. Although, once you walk out onto State Street, you're plugged into it. There are no Garrett's popcorns in Western Springs by my house, so.
And you do walk out onto State Street, right? You take a break between the podcast and the broadcast.
Every day after the podcast, I try to walk for about an hour, and I try to avoid stopping and buying Garrett's popcorn, which is really hard to do in the Loop, because there's one every block. That and a Walgreens, so.
And what do you do about all the mobs, the autograph seekers?
So far, no one has noticed me. So I walk every day for an hour, and not one person has stopped and said, "Hey, Steve Dahl." So, but it is winter, and I do have a hat on and a hood. So
that's not disheartening at all.
No, it's not disheartening, because I do keep my I kind of walk like this, because if you look up, you know, I mean, there are a lot of people that are they want either to give you a handout, or they're at, you know, like a handout sheet, or they want a handout, and so it can be very expensive to make eye contact with everybody down here, so, and dangerous.
So what are you thinking about during those walks?
During the walk, I really am trying to not think about anything. I try to kind of be meditative, and then I just am in the moment, and it's fun to look at, it's a people watch, you know, there's always something different happening down here, so that's kind of fun. I almost swore once. I got like two of the four letters of the word out, and the dump button was hit just to be on the safe side. And it's a good thing, because I kind of freaked out. I was like, "Oh my God!" But for the most part, I mean, there's a lot of swear. I don't know about the newspaper business, but there's a lot of swearing in radio, just off the air. You know, people. It's part of the lexicon, I guess. You know, so I'm pretty used to swearing, and then not swearing. So, and in terms of content, you know, I'm very familiar with the FCC rules and regulations about indecency.
So what's your vision for what you want to do at this station and for the medium in general, radio in general? Where's it going?
Well, at this station, I'd like to get good ratings for them, make a few of my ratings bonuses.
So my last question is how is the present-day Steve Dahl different from latter-day Steve Dahl as a broadcaster?
Present-day Steve Dahl doesn't take so many things for granted that maybe former Steve Dahl did. I'm really grateful to have this opportunity, and I'm trying not to squander it, I guess. I mean, you know, just I'm really aware of the fact that that it's a privilege, you know, to be able to talk to so many people, so.